And so this month, as you can see by the title, I do have things that I wanted to share with you guys. The previous months, I haven't really had anything that I wanted to share or something that I wasn't really loving. So I saw no point of doing a video for just like a couple items. I really wanted to get down and share with you guys everything that I have been loving. And I have been purchasing a lot of makeup lately. If you have seen my haul videos, I really have purchased some of the things. I only buy a couple things here and there, so I don't actually do like a haul video just for one or two items. Just like I don't do a video for my favorites if it's only one or two items. But I actually have a lot. I've tried a lot of products out, and I just wanted to share with you guys. So I'm gonna get started. I don't want to make this video so long, so let's get started with the very first thing. Is no particular order. I'm gonna start grabbing things off of my table. So the very first thing I want to share is with you this candles from Woodwink. Now I smelled this candle, but it was a different scent, on a client in her house when she was having her Halloween party, which is gonna be like 2 years back. And she told me like the aroma of the fragrance of that candle just penetrated the whole area around her living room and her dining room area. It was very, very strong. So for me, finding a candle that actually gives a potent smell is very difficult. I just find that some of them don't give a lot of payoff. So I asked her what it was or what brand it was, and she said it was from Woodwink and she got it from JCPenney. And JCPenney can be a little pricey, and on candles I don't want to spend so much money, but look at the size of that. I end up scoring it because this one's around $15 or $23, and I ended up getting it for about $9 at Kohl's with all my discounts and everything, and plus it was on sale. So I ended up getting this one, the pineapple and guava. This was the only one left in this scent, and it is delicious. It smells wonderful. You don't even have to burn it. It already gives out a fragrance. It's incredibly, like, the fragrance, if you like something like fruity smells, you'll love this one. But this was the only one that was left. I picked up one, and then I went back and I picked up a couple more, and this one was one of the ones that I picked up on my second trip to Kohl's. And I mean, you get used to the smell, so you don't smell it as much because your nose gets used to it. But other people who come in your house will actually smell it. And I had my father-in-law come in, and I thought my house was like pretty much disgusting because it was like there was stuff, it wasn't organized, it wasn't clean. But he said that there was a really good smell. He's like, it smells like pineapple in here. It smells really good. So, they're worth it. The other one is this 3-in-1. Which is the pineapple guava, which is the top one of that, raspberry macaroon, and tangerine papaya. Now it had 3 layers. I've already burned through 2 of them, two and a half. It's starting to fade into one right there, and they are incredible. The other one that always comes around during the fall time is from Glade. I bought it last year and I thought it was really good, and it smelled, like I said, I love candles that give a good payoff. And this one did just that, and it's a really good price. So this one is a pumpkin spice, and it has spice to it, but it does give you that pumpkin smell. So I came in and I walked into my apartment today and I smelled it all over the room, and it wasn't even on. It was just giving out the fragrance just like that. So when you burn it, it's even more, like, it penetrates the room even more. So I love these Glade candles, and I got the 2-for-1 where you get 2 candles for the price of, like, you get $1 off if you buy 2 of them. So I do really go need to stock up on them because I'm gonna be burning the hell out of them. Now this one item, I have seen so many people rave about them, especially on Instagram, and I've seen them, but I just haven't had like the chance to actually purchase them just because they're a little bit pricey, and I want to get my MAC stuff first and stock up on my kit. But I ended up finding out from a friend that she knew of a place where they were selling them for $1.99, and I was like, I'm there, tell me where it's at because I need to get some. And it's really the Pro Concealers from LA Girl. So I didn't just get one, I got a couple. And I tried them out and I'm loving them. They are so, so like pigmented, and they give really good coverage, and they're incredible. They're really nice. They don't crease because I've already applied them underneath. I use them as a highlight, and they have so many different colors. So I got a couple of them to add to my kit. As you can see, They're in a couple different ranges. I find these for less than, I think, wherever you it is that you look for them, they're like $5.99 and up. But this one's worth $1.99, so I'm have to take advantage before they, that person who owns the store realizes what they're selling it for and they hike up the prices. Okay, the very next product, and this is something that I have recently purchased in this past month, but I'm actually wearing it on my eyes today. Well, one of them, I'm wearing it on my eyes today, but it's the Makeup Geek pigments and eyeshadows. They are so beautiful, and I understand now why there are so many people raving about them, why there's so much hype around them, why they're worth every single penny. Okay, the one that I'm wearing is Insomnia. This one is the one that I'm wearing right now. This is a pigment. It's really pretty. It's very comparable to brown blue from MAC, I think it is. It's very comparable to that one, but of course Makeup Geek does it better. Sweet Dreams, which is a really nice nude with a little bit of shimmer. This is also a pigment. It's very comparable to Naked from MAC. It's really beautiful. I do have Utopia, but I have not used that one yet, so I have yet to try it out and see how I love it. So that is two of the pigments that I love from there, and I also have their shadows right here. I have them inside this kit, this MAC palette, just because I don't have nowhere else to put them, but I do need to get a magnet because they don't come with the magnet. I'm really loving the pigmentation out of this Corrupt shadow from Makeup Geek. Another one that I've been using quite a lot is Cocoa Bear. That's a really nice transitional color, especially when you're doing dark smoky eye. Really pretty. And the other one is Shimmer Shimmer. Yeah. And this one is really beautiful. Really beautiful. Really a lot of pigmentation out of these ones here. So they are very beautiful. Those are like the three ones that I've been loving too. And the brown doesn't fall that behind because it's really pigmented. It's just a neutral brown color. Another wand, and it's a glitter, so I might as well add it in here and mention it. It's the Stila Magnificent Metal Foil Finish eyeshadow. These ones are really beautiful. You can see it from here. Okay, they're really beautiful. They're like, it's glitter, but it's just packed in there. And then you use those eye drops that they sent and to actually put them on. But they're really beautiful. They're so glittery. They are amazing. I'll show you on the pan how they look. You might not be able to see all the reflex that shine off of the pan, but there's a couple other ones that I wanted to try from Stila, but not till I go for the store and I get the discounts is when I'm gonna be purchasing them, because I'd rather save a couple bucks. The other items that I buy, and these ones are from MAC. These are, I ended up getting a palette from MAC, and I ended up buying Blunt, which is like a nice brown blush, which is, I mean, it's a matte color. It's a matte shade, and it's really nice for contouring. I'm actually wearing it as well. And then I'm wearing this one here, which are new blushes. I forgot the name, but I guess I'll take it out so I can show you or tell you exactly what it is. This one is Spring Sheen. It's a really beautiful shade. I might not see it there. Maybe on my hand. It's a really nice color right there. And then the other one that I got, let me see if I can take it out. I don't want to stick all my nail into it or accidentally stick my nail into it. So, okay, is this one here. This one is Peachy. What the hell? Peachy Keen? Are you serious? No wonder it's one of my favorites. I already have this shit. What the hell? No wonder I've been using it a lot. No wonder I love it so much. I already have this one. I can't tell by them. I guess I just like swatched them. And I told her, oh, get me this one. Get me this one. I didn't even check the name of the blush. Shoot. I ended up getting the same one. Go figure. What the hell? Style. This is Style. This is Peachy Keen. Yeah. Serious? I was gonna depop this one too. As you can see, I hit pan, so I'm not lying to you. It is one of my favorites because I use it all the time. Oh, goodness, this is incredible. So I was gonna depop him, and now that I find out, when I took it out, and I'm like, Peachy Keen, I have that one already. What? What? I do have to get some powders though. I don't have none of those. Okay, few other things. One, two things left. Okay. My perfume, Prada. I love this one. Like a fragrance girl per se. I don't collect them. I buy one, use it up, and then buy another one. But I'm gonna say that this one, I probably had it around for, well, I didn't have it. I had a sample of it. And then I had like the little strip of paper with it on. And then I thought, you know what? I love this fragrance and I'm gonna buy it. So when I ran out of my Guess, what is it? Is it Guilty or Romance? I think it's Guess Guilty. When I ran out of that one, I decided to go buy the next one. And the next one up was Prada. I love this one. It smells wonderful. Which one is this one? Prada Candy. Love the fragrance. I've gotten compliments on this fragrance from people. And I guess the formula changes depending on your body. Every fragrance smells differently on different people, and for somebody to have given me a compliment on how good it smells says a lot about this one and my body chemistry with it. So yes, favorite for sure. And I will be, if I run out of this, I'm gonna be going and buying another one. This one for sure is gonna be another buy, another repurchase. Okay, and now I'm gonna be sharing my very last item. The very next thing, you probably heard, and I tell everybody about it, all my problems and my skincare problems and just my skin in general. I've been looking for a way to actually control my acne, and it's all over the place because of these damn birth control pills. But I had to stop taking birth control pills because they were just breaking me out like crazy. My hormones were all over the place. I was becoming really moody. I had headaches and all this stuff. So, and I thought, and this one was supposed to make everything a lot better, but it gave me all the damn side effects. The side effects were worse than what it was actually supposed to do for me. So the hell with it. I decided to toss that, and I decided to go and have my natural ways of regulating my own hormones. So for now, I'm doing benzoyl peroxide and everything to have them a little bit under control. So also, I've heard so much of the milk thistle, milk of magnesia, and I have heard so much about it. Actually, this girl recommended it to me. She said that it controlled her acne so much, and that was the only thing that has worked for her. I have so many people always telling me and giving me advice on how to take care of my skin, but I know myself, and I know it had to do with my insides and my hormones. So once my hormones get under control, I know everything will start showing up here. And well, it brings me to this. This is milk of magnesia, and it's used for encouraging bowel movements. Is it? Something like that. But you can also use it on your face. And if you have really oily skin, you can apply this as a primer right before you do your makeup. I have noticed that I have not been, especially in this heat right now, still suffering from heat in Southern California, especially with the sea, I get very oily, and I have noticed that it has kept my oil under control. I haven't had the need to actually blot as much, because I do get really oily, and I mean oily. I get oily. You don't understand. It's just horrible. So it has been with the benzoyl peroxide. I imagine my skin got a little bit more dry and it's not producing enough. So I do put cocoa oil in the nights just to moisturize my skin, because the benzoyl peroxide really dries it out. So in the morning I use this one, and this one also helps to shrink in the pores and help not reduce the oiliness, which then helps with the acne, so you don't get like inflammations or new ones that come out. So very good. I do recommend it if you have very oily skin or acne prone skin. You can apply this once a day and it will help you. The last thing I promise is BlowPro. BlowPro, the hairspray. It smells delicious. Every time I apply it on someone, they say, "What is that smell? That hairspray smells so good." And it really does smell really good. This one's the blowout spray. So for example, I did my hair right now, and it's flat, right? It's flat. I can apply a little bit of this hairspray just around this area here. It's running out too. Oh my god, it does smell really good. And then just, you know, toss away a little bit. I can even like do this and then like toss it back, and it'll give me a lot more volume. As you can see, what a difference did it make. Great. And you can't, it's not gonna be like those sticky hairsprays. Really nice hairspray too. So Blopro, it's a little bit pricey, so you're gonna have to like, I think they sell it at Ulta or Sephora, but they're a little pricey. They're like around $20-$25 for professional use. Like, unless a person may be paying me quite a lot for this, I'm not gonna be using it on them unless it's like something like this. Then I would really wear it. This is quite an expensive product, but it's worth it. Like, it smells so good, and it really leaves your hair really nice and tousled without having that cringy feeling hair. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this favorites video. Tell me what is your favorite item for this month. I would love to know and check it out and see that if that's something that I can add to my own personal kit. If you guys enjoyed watching this video, I'll see you guys on the next one. And always, if you haven't subscribed, do so. Bye. This is milk of... There's people. I'm gonna be burning the hella. I'm gonna be burning the... This is milk of Winnie. The other one that always comes around during the fall time. Oh my god. Oh, can't say oh my god. Sorry. Sorry. I had to close that window because there was people passing by and I felt like they were probably listening, eavesdropping on me. So that's kind of embarrassing, and my kids are over there laughing. But the good thing is that this video is finally over. There's definitely more to share in my favorites. So I guess we'll leave with that note. If you guys enjoyed watching this video, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Closed door, closed window, kids in the other room. You could still hear them. They're over there googling away. They're probably watching some video or something. Another YouTuber making videos instead of watching mine. This is milk of magnesia. This is milk of magnesia, and it's used for